Okay, so we've got a structure that resembles what you would see in this sodium unit. Let's also create a new section here that we're going to call, let's just call this, no template here. We're going to call this one the equipment hierarchy. Now under this list of equipment here, I'm going to include two major categories. We're going to look at all the temperature transmitters and all the level transmitters. I'd like to do this by creating a couple of templates, one for temperature transmitters, one for level transmitters. So I'll go in here and just create a brand new template. I'll just call this, let's call this temperature transmitter collection, something like that. And I'll also create one called a level transmitter collection. These are new templates. There we go. Now within this, I would like to put my level transmitters and my temperature transmitters. Now the level transmitters, if you recall, I said that the level transmitter is something that can be moved from one unit to the other. So, you know, within my cell, let's go back here in elements. Within my cell, I can have a level transmitter here, here. Those level transmitters, if I decide to put them in this equipment list under level transmitters, then if I remove them from one of these cells, or if I remove the whole cell, I don't necessarily want the level transmitter to be removed from this equipment list. Because as I mentioned, we can use those level transmitters in different places. But what about the temperature transmitters? I had said that the temperature transmitters, once they're in a cell, they're in there for good. Now you're probably going to want to include them in your equipment list under the temperature transmitter collection, but you also want that temperature transmitter to be removed from this collection if it's ever removed from the cell, if the cell's ever deleted. If the parent's ever deleted, you simply don't need to keep that around because you know that that transmitter is gone, that temperature transmitter. So that's going to be established with a weak connection to this temperature transmitters group. I'm going to add a couple of new collections here, the ones that I just defined. So we're going to add a new child element, and this one's going to be the, let's go with the temperature transmitter collection. There we go. That's a new element based on that template. And we'll add another, level transmitter collection here. That's based on the template I just created. So what remains to be done is now I need to establish a new reference type to allow a specific weak reference from this collection here to the transmitters that I'm going to be putting underneath that. See, I want that reference to be weak. I don't have a reference type like that now. Now I could go into the library here and just create the reference types myself. But there's, again, there's a nice way to do this from within the element templates. And we always recommend you do this through the element templates. I can go, let's go to the temperature transmitter collection. I can do new, and within here I can do add a template reference. This is going to be adding a new reference type for me, creating a new one based on the current template I've selected. Now the child reference element template I want to use is this. This is going to be the temperature transmitter. I will go ahead and edit the reference type because this is the one that I don't want the default strong. I want this to be a weak reference. So here's my new reference type. This is kind of the big finish here. It's the reference type between the collection, the temperature transmitter collection, and the transmitter itself. In this case, we're going to make that weak. And we do that because if you delete the parent, the cell that contains that, we don't want that temperature transmitter hanging around here. We know it's in the trash. There's no point in having it around. So it's allowed to have that as a parent and that as a child, which you'll see is helpful when we start making references back in the set of elements. Yeah, when we start adding this. So there we go. Now this picked up that we were modifying that temperature transmitter template. We're not going to make any changes to that. We'll just keep that. And then the last one, yeah, that now created this new reference type. Let's do the same thing for the level transmitter. Actually, you know what? Let's do it like this. Let's go out and make use of this now that I've created that, we'll go out and make use of that temperature transmitter reference type. So what I'd like to do is, underneath my temperature transmitter collection, I'm going to add, this is going to be not a new child element, but add an element reference. Remember, this temperature transmitter, it already exists over here. All I want to do is put it underneath here. I can do it by drag and drop, but I can also do it by adding an element reference. And watch what happens when we specify that the referenced element is going to be one of those temperature transmitters. You'll notice that there's going to be a change to what we see listed here. So let me go out and find just that temperature transmitter. We'll go with temperature transmitter 1. And now that we've detected that that's the one we're interested in, look what we've done here. We've restricted this just to those allowed reference types. And here's the suggestion, you know, for your users, that this is the one that you want them to use. Now, they also have the option to use these others, but we're trying to direct them to make this specific reference type. That's why I was mentioning earlier, we may in the future support restricting them to only using this reference type. Right now it's just one of the ones listed. There we go. So now we have a reference type to there, but it's a reference type that's a weak reference type, the one that I defined. Now I could have also done that by just doing a drag and drop. So I could grab this temperature transmitter. If you remember, just dragging and drop, it has the effect of doing and adding in a reference. So when I do this, as you can see, it detects that we're trying to add a reference, and it's showing me just those reference types that are available. And again, as we said before, we're going to choose that one that we've defined. I'll do the same for this one. I'll go ahead and drag this, drop it on there. That does the same thing as add an element reference, and that's the reference type we want. Well, so far so good. Let's go back and do the same thing for our level transmitter collection here. Yeah, for the level transmitter collection, we want to create a new reference type. This reference type, though, is going to be a regular strong reference type. We don't need this to be the weak reference type, because remember, we can reuse those level transmitters. And if we delete them from the tank or from the cell, we don't need to delete it from this list. So we'll add a reference, add a new template reference. The child reference that we're going to be referencing here is going to be the level transmitters. We don't need to do this, but I'll go ahead and just demonstrate. Yeah, see there, we're going to have the default strong reference. And now here, again, here's our big finish. This is now a new reference type called level transmitter collection to the level transmitters that are underneath of it. And that's going to be a strong reference type. These are the allowed parents and the allowed children. I don't need to edit the template, so I'll go ahead and just acknowledge, check all this in, and now back in the elements level, now I'm ready to, I can either drag and drop or just add an element reference. Let's add an element reference and then we'll drag and drop. Right click on here, we're going to add references to level transmitter 1, 2, and 3. So it's add element reference. We can actually go out and find multiple if we wanted to at this point. Here's my level transmitter. And notice the list of reference types available. That one that we just created, which is what I want. There we go. I'll drag this level transmitter. Use that default. I'll drag this level transmitter. And we'll get that default reference type as well. Okay. With everything checked in, you know, you may be wondering, what was the point of all this? And I'll admit, it's a real subtlety that can easily just escape you at this point. I think the best way to demonstrate this is to watch what happens when you delete one of these cells. What we've got now is a structure in which the cells all have strong relationships to those things that are underneath of it. That's a strong relation to the transmitter. Cell 1 has a strong relation to the level transmitter. At the same time, if we look at the equipment collection, the level transmitter collection, these are strong relationships with that parent there. Because if we delete this or delete this cell, cell 2, for example, if we delete that, we can reuse this level transmitter. That's no problem. We don't throw that in the trash. We reuse it. We put it somewhere else. This, on the other hand, this temperature transmitter collection, it has a weak relationship to this right here, to these unorganized underneath of it. We can see that if we go into the child elements here, and if we choose to look at them by reference types. See, if we look at this by reference type, we can see that this is using this, the TT collection temp transmitter reference type. That's the reference type it's using. Now compare that to, you know, if we take a look at the child levels here, or the child elements here, that's using a different reference type. And that reference type, in fact, is a strong reference type. So because this reference type, the relationship here is weak, that means that if I do delete cell 2, I'll go ahead and do that right now. If I delete cell 2, and watch what happens. It doesn't happen right away, but after a little while, what you'll notice is because cell 2 is deleted and because this temperature transmitter relationship here, this transmitter relationship to this collection is a weak relationship, then after the cleanup process runs, and it runs on a cycle, we're simply going to throw this element away. So I'll just keep refreshing until we see that change. Now while I'm waiting, I want to double check and make sure that this relationship here, the TT collection to the temp transmitter, make sure that that is a weak connection. So I would go into the reference types, I'll look for the temperature transmitter collection to the temp transmitter, and yeah, there it is, its reference strength is weak. So what we should be seeing here, any second now, is that this temperature transmitter should be deleted from here. And there we go. If you notice, this has just shown me that this transmitter 2, which was deleted up here when we deleted cell 2, no longer shows up in the collection. Now just to show you, I was refreshing that over and over again, didn't get any results. I then checked it in again and then refreshed and got results. So, but there's a cycle that goes on, I believe it's like once every 15 minutes or so, in which we clean up those child, or the, I should call them orphan elements that no longer have any strong or composition parents. And that's what we saw in this case. Now did you notice this level transmitter number 2, it did not get deleted when cell number 2 got deleted. And that's because it had a strong reference to its parent, this collection here. So because it was a strong, not a weak reference, then that was not removed as one of those orphan elements. Now I'd like to finish by just making a couple of points. You know, this cleanup mechanism that we just saw, I don't think that's the best feature about using your own user-defined reference types. You know, it's nice that if you have weak references, the objects disappear once the last parent disappears. It's nice that it deletes it. That might save you some embarrassment from, you know, having that obsolete piece of equipment show up in an analysis or a report. But the real benefit to this, one of the greatest benefits to this, is that when you're adding new objects here, you can suggest to your users what type of relationship that object should have. As I add element references here, once you know what the element is, you have the option of specifying to people, you know, what type of relationship that should be. So with this level transmitter, if I select that, you notice it's the user presented now with a choice of what reference type he's going to use, including the reference type that defaults, which is the one that you were interested in having them use. But one of the things we'd like to do is allow searches and also the presentation layer to obey these, you know, these reference type choices. So, you know, right now with these reference types, we can make use of them when we build structures. But imagine in the future being able to look at a display and only show those elements that have the, you know, cell to level transmitter's reference type, or, you know, hide everything except those objects that have the TT collection to temp transmitter reference type.